It's been almost 3 years since the release of the first generation of AirPods Pro. Apple finally releases second generation of AirPods Pro, and 52 Audio already got it. The second generation is pretty similar to the first generation in appearance, but this time it integrates an upgraded H2 chip and supports Bluetooth 5.3. The capability of active noise cancellation is greatly enhanced. Next, we're going to take apart the AirPods and charging case and show it to you guys. The front of the box is printed with AirPods Pro, some info labels are pasted on the side. The charging case is printed on the back. Open the box, it contains some documents, AirPods itself, a USB-C to lightning cable, and 3 pairs of ear tips. They were extra small, small, and large, respectively. It's almost the same as the previous generation, but there is actually a lanyard loop on the side. And built-in speakers is at the bottom. Open the lid. The serial number and specs info are printed inside the lid. Model is A2700. The input and output are the same, 5 volts, 1 amp. Rated capacity is 523 mAh. Take out the AirPods. The golden pogo pins are at the bottom for charging. Here is the AirPods Pro 2. The oval part on the back is the microphone. Here is the charge bar that can adjust the volume, and this is the skin detect sensor for in-ear detection. The oval hole on the top can drop and balance the ear pressure. The silver contacts are used for charging, which integrates call mic. The L and R logos can easily distinguish them. ChargeLab Power ZKM002C shows the charging power is about 2 watts, and the wireless charging power is 1.7 watts. The total weight is 61.5 grams, the charging case is 51 grams, and the AirPods are only 10.6 grams. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart. Start from the charging case. Use the spudger to separate the charging case. 2 flat cables are connected to the wireless charging coil and lightning port, respectively. The lightning port is covered with a metal plate and fixed with screws. The pairing button and charging coil are attached to the charging case. Slowly separate the wireless charging coil. And here is the pairing button. The internal module can be divided into 3 parts. 2 batteries are attached to the front and back of the PCB to improve space utilization. Next, separate the lightning port and take out all cables inside. Now we can take a closer look at the charging case. This opening can balance air pressure with a layer of waterproof membrane and metal mesh. The metal frame integrates a lanyard loop and is used to fix the speaker and lightning port. The metal sheet is on the edge of the PCB for grounding. And the metal plate is connected to the metal sheet. Here is the speaker of charging case. Then remove the upper part. The graphite thermal sheet is pasted on the back. The magnet can attract the lid tightly. Those magnets can attract and fix the AirPods tightly, just like this. The whole element can detect the opening and closing of the charging case. Next, let's separate different parts of the charging case. Here is the layout of the internal module, and then we will introduce every single part. Firstly, the flat cable was connected to the pogo pins and fixed with glue. And the BDP connector is at the end. Here is the power indicator, and the speaker is here. A QR code is on the back of the speaker. The wireless charging coil is connected to the main PCB through the flat cable, and the micro switch of the pairing button is in the middle. This chip on the back is used to detect the coil's temperature. Here is the wireless charging receiver circuit, a chip marked with 5LJ. The Broadcom wireless charging management IC is on the back and adopts BGA package. A flat cable connects to the battery pack. A metal shield is on the back of the battery connector. There is a protection board for each battery. Those ICs are covered with translucent glue. Model is A2798. Battery capacity is 523 mAh, which is the total capacity for 2 batteries. Manufacturer is Sonwanda Electronics. Next, let's talk about the internal PCB of the charging case. The Bluetooth antennas are in the front and back. This multi-protocol Bluetooth 5 SoC from NORDIC adopts a wafer-level chip scale package. It supports NFC, ANT, ANT Plus, and 2.4 GHz proprietary protocol. Here is the Apple Ultra Wideband chip U1 marked with 2ZRT. Flip to the back, this largest chip is also an Apple proprietary IC. Then here is the Ultra Low Power chip from STMicroelectronics, which integrates ARM Cortex, M4 32-bit MCU, and FPU. The audio amplifier IC is from Maxim, used to play sound to help you easily locate the AirPods. Here is the USB charging IC from NXP. The memory is marked with E8ELW. Next, let's remove the ear tips and take apart the AirPods Pro 2. Use a heat gun to remove the glue. And we can pry along the gap to open the AirPods Pro. Here is the connector that connects the Apple H2 SIP. Disconnect it. It can be divided into three parts: front, back, and handle. The battery, speaker unit, and MEMS microphone are under the H2. Take out the battery and remove the transparent frame. The hole on the side can work with the transparent frame to enhance the bass effect. The battery is from Samsung SDI, model is A2731, and rated capacity is 49.7 mAh, and the rated voltage is 3.66 volts. A circle of FPC is fixed around the battery. And then take out the speaker unit. We can clearly see the flat cables and MEMS microphone. An infrared distance sensor on the cable can tell if you're wearing AirPods. The curved iron wire is used to fix the ear tips and MEMS microphone. Take out the wire. The black plastic can insert into the tiny groove of your ear tips. The dynamic unit is black. And the diameter is about 11 mm. There is a NORA IC at the end of the flat cable. Next, let's move to the back part. The iron block can attract the magnets of the charging case and adjust the center of gravity. And here is the Apple H2 chip. Then let's take apart the final part, the handle. There is a flat cable running through the entire handle. A touch sensor is under the shallow groove of the handle, so you can adjust the volume and pass the music. Another MEMS microphone for phone calls is at the bottom, and the golden Bluetooth antenna is in here. The third MEMS microphone is marked with S289, used for noise cancellation, a chip on the flat cable of the touch sensor. The back of the Apple H2 chip is printed with 33dp, and two accelerometers are next to the H2 chip to detect the motion. Well, that's all components of the brand new Apple AirPods Pro 2. After taking it apart, we found that Apple has taken its integration into a whole new level by stacking all those components. And the flat cables are widely used in the AirPods and integrate a large number of components. Because of the low-power H2 chip, its battery life can be up to 6 hours, while the battery capacity is almost the same as the previous generation. Okay, that's all for today's video. This is 52 Audio. You can also click the corners to check the teardown of AirPods 3. If you want to see more like this, please click the subscribe button and leave your comments below. See you in the next video. Bye!